good evening and welcome to Pound Posse Presents. Zach, did I hear you kind of jamming in there? Yeah, you were getting into it. See, what you guys get robbed of who are watching it on YouTube is the opening segment, which if you scroll way back to the beginning, it is posted, but it's one of my all-time favorite songs that just kind of applies with a little video montage. And it's a jamming tune, so I like it. And Zach was just in there jamming, and that always tickles my fancy. But anyway, here we are, almost to the end of February. Getting there, it's a short month. We've been kind of lucky with snow, but looks like we're getting more. It's been cold. Hope everybody's keeping their animals inside. Hope that everybody is keeping an eye on neighborhood animals who might not be being treated the way they should. You know, animal abuse, that's what it is. And, you know, you got to say something if it's happening, because you're going to be the only voice that that animal has. Anyway, I'm kind of all over the place tonight. I've had a headache that won't quit. I feel like I'm getting sick. I was out in the cold a little too much this week, but all for good reason. So I can't really complain other than that I have to suck it up and get through it. So the reason why I was out in the cold on Wednesday is because this week, former Bully Breed Rescue President Heidi Luters appeared in front of a judge in Bridgeport Court to answer for her charges. Zach, let's get those Fairfield Five pictures up. And, of course, she pled not guilty. That's standard procedure. But she had to file her plea. And the case that is against her has kind of been dubbed the Fairfield Five, where, you know, if you've by some chance not heard the horrifying story, there were five dogs who were in her care that were alleged to be in sanctuaries and one in a foster home that were starved to death. And when I say not starved to death, they weren't just dead. They weren't just carcasses. They were decomposed to the point where they were just bones in crates. There were also a lizard and a snake, but they've kind of slipped through the cracks a bit. So these five dogs were just, their end was brutal. And the home that this occurred in was a rental. And the place was just trashed beyond belief. In addition to the crates with these poor dogs locked in them, there was feces all over the floor. It looks ankle deep to me. Garbage strewn everywhere. And amongst the garbage, this is really heart-wrenching, were like unopened bags of dog food. There was clearly a drug problem where there were pill bottles and used needles and, you know, the little plastic bags and just literal garbage strewn everywhere. The house is pretty well trashed. The landlady is devastated. There's, you know, really nowhere she's been able to turn to try to get her life back together. But of course, the focus of the show is the dogs. And it took a while, but the charges were filed against her for the damage to the property as well as the animal abuse here. And the charges for abuse were entered as misdemeanors, while the property damage was a felony. So the charges of abuse were actually elevated in court which was a beautiful thing. And they are now felonies. And it was very interesting to be there in court. And I was, of course, honored to stand with my Desmond's Army family. We filled the front row, a couple other rows. Heidi had nobody with her in court. She was alone except for her lawyer. She was ordered not to own or care for any animals while this case is ongoing. She was ordered to sign up for a program that would include random drug testing and I guess some, oh look, somebody's calling me, that's not nice. Hey, I'm on the air, I'll have to call you back. I didn't even mean to answer that. Anyway, so yeah, she was ordered not to own any animals except, you know, be in their company incidentally, like if she's over a relative's house. She has to go for further evaluation, and she has to subject herself to random drug testing, which is a beautiful thing. Sadly, my notes are all out of order, but that's okay because I know what I'm talking about, I think. So yeah, it was a very good showing for this court appearance. And really, it was just the arraignment. It's just the beginning. It's going to take a very long time to move through the system with this case. The advocate, you know, Desmond's law is going to be used in this case. And the advocate for the case was appointed Ken Bernhard, which certainly is a good thing. There were a few attorneys that filed to be able to be the advocate, and you know, fortunately the one that will probably work the best was chosen, and you know, we've got every confidence in him. He has done a Desmond's Law case in the past and done well, so you know, all hopes are that he will be able to succeed as well. Sadly, the Heidi's lawyer is trying to, you know, if you've seen any of the news articles, trying to say that, you know, she's a victim of the opioid epidemic. But you know what? I'm not buying that because she had other animals in that house that she didn't starve to death. So how do you pick and choose who you're going to neglect and abuse? How do you pick who's going to die? You've got something going in your mind. You're not that out of it if you're taking care of who you want to take care of and, you know, not anybody else. So we'll see how that works in court. Her next appearance is going to be March 15th. And, you know, there were a whole lot of people who were there on Wednesday. And, you know, as you can see here, there were signs and, you know, people were pretty well behaved. There was news coverage. And going forward, we're going to need respectful but large presence at every appearance. You know, we can't let this one kind of die out or slip through the cracks. It's very high profile. It has been since November when it broke, the story broke. And no matter whether it takes, you know, 6 months, a year and a half, 2 years, it doesn't matter, and you know, it could take that long. There needs to be a good showing at every court appearance because we need to impress upon the judge, and I would say the judge, if it stays in front of this judge got it by allowing the charges to be elevated and by ordering her not to have animals and, you know, by sending her for the further, you know, having her enroll in the program so she gets drug tested and, you know, urine tested, whatever. She kind of gets what's going on here, and that's important. You know, not every judge gets the seriousness or wants to entertain, if you will, the seriousness of animal abuse cases. So I'm hoping that it stays before this judge. I'm not familiar enough with the process to know whether it will or not, but kudos to her for doing the right thing here already, and, you know, appointing an advocate and taking it seriously and elevating the charges. You know, it's a good start, and hopefully going forward as well, her attorney's claim will just be totally thrown out of the window, because it's mind-boggling how you use excuses to cover your tracks when you've committed a heinous act as this was. So it's definitely one to watch, and I'll try to keep my viewing public updated as best I can. And again, the next court date is March 15th. Once again, the Bridgeport Court on Golden Hill Street, I think it is. Be there, be respectful, and make sure that we get justice for the Fairfield Five. That's what it's all about. Alrighty, so moving right along, I'll take the camera back for a hot second. I would like to give props to Gary Kaufman of Nobody Starves on Long Island, We Can Feed Them All. That is the name of the organization and the Facebook page. And he sprung Max. Dun, dun, dun. Let's get Max up there. Dun, dun, dun. He sprung Max from the town of Hempstead Animal Shelter. And Max is now one step closer to home and already benefiting from being in a much smaller, less stressful environment where he's getting so much more one-on-one time and exercise. For updates and to find out more, you can visit his Facebook page. And, you know, his existing Facebook page, Mighty Max Needs a Home, will still be operating to cover Max's journey. You know, it's something that the team and I discussed just to sort of keep the interest up, to keep the people who are used to seeing him there exposed to what's going on with him. And, you know, these are some great pictures. This one right here was his ride to his new facility. And clearly he was very excited. I love the flying ears. That bag of cat food did not survive the trip. But, you know, how could you hold it against such a happy moment? You know, here is Max with a former Town of Hempstead Animal Shelter kennel buddy, I guess. And you could see they're just tearing it up and having a great time. That's Max in the back there, again, with the flying ears. I can't even stand how cute he is. He is such a good dog. And there's a video that's posted that I was tagged to today that he's running around and he's just having a great time, and he looks so much better already. He was a dog that was just so stressed out, adopted and returned for being, you know, too bouncy and, you know, blah, blah, blah. You know, these dogs need more attention and more one-on-one time than they get in a very large shelter. And that's not the fault of the shelter. You know, thankfully the town of Hempstead allows volunteers to even go in there and interact with the dogs. And, you know, if not for that, the dogs would have nothing. There's shelters here in Connecticut that don't provide anything like the Town of Hempstead Animal Shelter does. And so, you know, I'm always gonna say props to them. But, you know, just seeing Max running around and being happy, and, you know, it's a great thing. And so he really is one step closer to home, because he'll be less stressed out. He'll be more relaxed. He'll have a lot of his, what do I want to say, anxiety kind of loved out of him. So really, lots of thanks to Gary. And who knows, maybe we can even get Gary to bring Max up onto the show. That would be really cool, because I certainly wouldn't mind seeing Max again. And that would have to be a kind of a big night. We'd have to have Kristen come back to see him again, and Yeah, I can see it now. Maybe a road trip with some of my lady friends down there. Yeah. Anyway, I digress. So next up, another sponsor dog from the town of Hempstead Animal Shelter is Juniper. And I think this is such a creative picture. You know, I'm not good like that. I wish I was. I don't even have like the software and the programs and I can't even figure out how to do stuff like that. But anyway, Juniper has blossomed from a scared stray into a dog who wants nothing more than to snuggle with her shelter friends. While still wary of strangers, once she knows you, she treats you like a friend. Juniper is interested in other dogs, but really doesn't know how to act around them. So she'd need lots of guidance and a patient housemate to help her along. Now at a year in the shelter, which is really sad, waiting for someone to choose her, Juniper could use all the shares she can get to help put her in front of more potential adopters. So again, all of these dogs are on the Pound Posse Presents Facebook page. Juniper Needs a Forever Home is Juniper's own page. So, you know, if you can share her on, you know, anything you've got going on social media, that would certainly help. All these dogs are up. So share away. If you're interested in Juniper, and she's a beautiful girl, and she really is a love. There's videos of her just not wanting, you know, people to stop petting her, and it's just so terribly endearing, and it's heartbreaking. You know, the longer they wait, the sadder it is. So anyway, if you're interested in Juniper, oh my God, I can't even. Juniper, please call the Town of Hempstead Animal Shelter. And the number there is 516-785-5220, 516-785-5220. Next up, we have Sandy. Zach's like, oop, my turn. Alrighty, so Sandy we've seen on the show a couple of times before. And unfortunately, she's just made her 1 year mark at the shelter. She is as sweet as she is cute. If you remember me talking about the dog who was dragging her blanket around the kennel and just broke my heart, this is her. She deserves a chance at a solid forever home. Sandy was purchased as a puppy and surrendered by her family after displaying a dislike for people near her food. So she needs a home with some dog smarts who will work with her and help her through the issue and not bail on her. Sandy really likes other dogs and is friendly with strangers. She has her own Facebook page. It's Adopt Sandy, which is all one word, no space. And she is also at the Town of Hempstead Animal Shelter. And the number there is 516-785-5220. Once again, that's 516-785-5220. Now, I'll take the camera for a hot second. Huh? Yeah, I know. I saw that. She's peeking over the top of my head. And I saw right away you weren't trying to give me ears because they didn't line up. Yeah, Zach is good for it if you've not ever seen it before. When he's fading those pictures in and out and things line up just right. When the animal's ears line up over my head and it looks like I have big dog ears. And he gets very proud of himself when he can do that. And, you know, hey, it's funny. It's all good. Even I get a kick out of it. So I was going to air a dog tonight, and I saw this afternoon the best news of all. It's always the best news for me to have to change things up on the show was when they get adopted. So congratulations to Kingston from Town of Hempstead Animal Shelter, who is a older Cane Corso who is just such a sweetheart. And he went home, and so congratulations to Kingston. So instead of Kingston, we are substituting Tipsy. And Tipsy, tell me, that's not a dead ringer for Max.
Oh, yeah.
Tipsy looks a lot like my little Max, and she's actually even tinier. She's a new arrival at the shelter who came in when her owner was hospitalized. She's a little thing, not quite 10 pounds, but she's a whole lot of cute. Tipsy is a tripod. She is missing a back leg. She is social with other dogs, but no cats or small children for her. She's a new arrival. Again, there's not a lot of information about, you know, how she does or you know, what's going on. But I did, if you look on my personal Facebook page, if we're friends, there is a video, and she is just a little cutie. She really, really looks like my Max, and, you know, that sticking up hair on her head just makes me want to give her a colored mohawk, but, you know, a little bit of colored hair gel, and that's what I want to do to Max. It's terrible. But yeah, except for the one ear up and one ear down thing, like her face, she's like a dead ringer for my boy, who just turned 3 this week, by the way. Surprised for both of us that, you know, I haven't either killed myself or him. But anyway, I digress. If you are interested in Tipsy, the number is 516-785-5220. Once again, Town of Hempstead Animal Shelter, 516-785-5220. Next up, we have Chip. And what a handsome, handsome dog. Chip is about a year old and still very much a puppy. He was recently returned for just that. So here we have a fabulous dog whose people failed him on many levels looking for a better situation in life. You know, if you aren't going to be able to handle bringing up a puppy, you shouldn't even try. You know, puppies are work. Puppies require training, and puppies require attention and, you know, positive discipline, and, you know, they don't know how to act. You have to show them. So, you know, now you have a dog whose family couldn't be bothered, didn't have the time, etc., etc. So this poor guy has missed out on a lot of his formative education. But you know what? He's still sweet. He gets along with cats and dogs, and he will be the best boy he can be with the training that he hasn't been giving until now. So to find out more or to apply, you can visit barklongisland.org. That's BARRKLI.org. There you will find out how to apply or, you know, message for more information. And currently, Chip is located in Massachusetts. Next up, we have Lily. And Lily is a beautiful girl. She was left in a dog run and was attacked regularly by larger dogs for food. Now, you know, I don't understand people. She does bear some physical scars, but her past is behind her, and Lily is ready to move on to better things. She loves people, and even after all she has been through, she is still loving towards other dogs. Lily is about 30 pounds of amazing and available through Forgotten Friends of Long Island. For more information, you can email FFOLI, Forgotten Friends of Long Island, FFOLI.info@gmail.com. FFOLI.info@gmail.com. And, you know, she's just a beauty. I love her with her little decorative foo-foo-y stuff there. And, you know, I'm sure that she is that dog who is just going to be so grateful to be in a better situation, which clearly she already is in, but it's just not a home. So let's see if we can make that happen for her. All right, next up. As of yesterday, Woody was the only dog left in the shelter. Not a lot of info I could find on him, but he is listed as good with other dogs and cats, but prefers no children. You know, and it's not a slam to the shelter, and, you know, don't anybody go getting upset, but, you know, the more information that there is about these dogs, the more it helps to get them placed. Woody looks like a really handsome guy, and he's probably a really good dog to boot. You know, are there other pictures of Woody, Matt, up there? Yeah, there we go. Look at that face. Look at those eyes. Isn't he beautiful?
Yes.
Zach's like ooh-ooing in there. He's just gorgeous. I mean, yeah, his face reminds me just a little bit of Mojo, which is kind of heartbreaking, but, you know, it's all good. He's just a handsome, handsome boy. Unfortunately, you're going to have to do your own finding out about him. One more picture, no?
No.
There was only two?
Yeah.
I thought I had three. Okay. So,
I didn't lie to you on your card.
Huh?
I haven't been lied to.
There's only two. Alrighty, well, you haven't been lied to, but maybe I forgot to download it, or I downloaded it to the wrong place. Who knows? I mean, I've done worse. So, yeah, anyway, for, you know, any of the shelters that put up, you know, the Pet Finder posts too, yeah, it's all fine and well to put your contact information and what you have to do to adopt and this and that, but, you know, there should be just a little bit more for the dogs. Anyway, if you're interested in Woody, he is available at the Stratford Animal Control, and their number is 203-385-4068. Once again, that's 203-385-4068. Let's see if we can get, you know, that shelter cleared by getting this one last lonely dog out of there. That would be a beautiful thing. Alrighty, so, dun, 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 dun. I'm going to say peace, love, and dogs. Until next week, thank you very much for watching, and good night.